Now that the GT4 pack for Assetto Corsa Competizione got released, there is finally a somewhat similar car to those in Automobilista 2, namely the Ginetta GT4. Yes, they are different versions. ACC features the pure GT4 and AMS2 the Super Cup variant. But the only real difference here is that the GT4 has about 25 brake horsepower more than the Super Cup version, which in turn means the handling should be directly comparable as the rest of the cars is identically, and 25 bhp more could only lead to a bit snappier behavior. With that in mind, let's also not forget that Greaser isn't completely done with Automobilista 2 yet, since there will be some additional content coming, as well as a few minor hotfixes, or rather physics tweaks. Additionally, both games have different goals, so to say. Assetto Corsa Competizione tries to simulate GT3 and GT4 cars exclusively, while Automobilista 2 has one physics engine for a great variety of cars. But as it is generally accepted that ACC is actually pretty darn close to reality, I figured a little comparison between the two Ginettas could give us a slight idea of where AMS2 currently stands, physics-wise. So, with that said, I am just going to let the lap run through while giving you my thoughts on the car's handling. First of all, the Ginetta in ACC feels really nice and steady. It instantly complies to steering inputs and rarely over or understeers. And like I already said in my GT4 pack review, its braking performance is out of this world, as you are able to brake insanely late and deep into corners without unsettling the Ginetta noticeably more. The Automobilista 2 Ginetta, on the other hand, is a bit more challenging to drive. It has a tendency to easily oversteer, especially under acceleration, which is generally a trait all cars in Automobilista 2 have, and braking feels a bit weird as well. When you fully step on the brakes, the wheels instantly lock up, the car gets all twitchy, and it's generally very hard to trail brake into corners. The main difference though is how the two cars corner. ACC's Ginetta feels very connected to the road, and lap time lies in being as smooth as possible. Whereas in Automobilista 2, it seemed like lap time can only be gained by taking more risks, in a way where through the last section on Brands Hatch, for example, the Ginetta would instantly slide after turning in. Like, it almost always played out the following. Turn in, instantly countersteer, make a somewhat controlled slide through the corner. A fact in this could be that ACC has custom default setups, which are decently adjusted for the according track, while AMS2 has just one default setup for every car, which may be fitting for one track, but is horrible for another. Overall, it can be said that Assetto Corsa Competizione's Ginetta feels not necessarily better, but nicer overall, I guess. Like, it responds to your steering inputs calmly, and under braking is very steady. Automobilista 2's Ginetta, on the other hand, is twitchy under braking and easily unsettled. But before I end this video, I just want to note that this is not a full comparison between ACC and AMS2, but rather just an assertion of how close AMS2 currently comes to ACC, as it is generally considered the best simulator right now. So yeah, if you did enjoy this video or could get something useful out of it, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!